Hey, well, good afternoon. Welcome to the Dream Labs of Dr. Contrast Live. And boy, I'm really beginning a program here today. I just apologize. I've lost the chat line series here, so I won't be able to really touch base with you all. And if you have any commentary to make, I'm really sorry for the fact that we've got this little bit of confusion here. But I just wanted to go back in today and maybe start a few little products design sketches here and go through some like air purifier materials and the like. So it'd be kind of nice to just kind of go through some ballpoint pen sketches, keep them nice and simple, and without a doubt, just go back in and really develop just some really nice little thumbnail sketches on ideation materials. I think the thing I want to really concentrate on too as well in this exercise today is how critical it is to kind of build through a sketch and just kind of generate an idea and come through it all and go very nicely and smoothly with the idea of being very lucid, at the same time being structural, but at the same time putting some concept work down. So let's kind of get started here, and let's do this. Let's start with a little concept. I always like to start a program like this, and just a little thumbnail sketch of getting this material down, just starting through it, and then just getting the volume in. Just getting it squared away like so. Now come back in, and put a little bit of roundness into this thing. Let's get these shapes together here. Pull that, then put a little bit of crown on it. And just change the shape of this guy. Just kind of put a little more form to it here. So that's that to that. Let's bring that on through. Just develop a little bit of sidewall change here. Just kind of get a little more highlight. Notice the real lucid here, radius. Land that out just a bit. Come through the top, put a little bit of crown on this guy. Just got some section to it. Just kind of, structurally speaking here, just going to get that up on top. Put that up on top here. Let's just take this line right on through and just kind of bring this into some sort of nice little play here. A little form study in the middle. No, it's a real lucid sketch. It's just nice and easy. Come through it again. And just developing a little bit of shadow behind this thing. And let's go back in and get this all rolling here. Let's put a little bit of contour in this thing, a bit of shadow, a bit of tone in this here. And just a little bit of detail line right here. Let's just kind of put some stroke pattern in this thing, air distribution. And again, a little tone there. Going to come right through the form here, put a little bit of shading in this thing, give more character to it. Sometimes it's nice too, just add a little bit of contour to it, a little bit of tone and shading. Take a pencil here and just kind of tone in a little bit, get that brake line to work. Come through this core area here, just pick up a little bit of that. Run that through and just pick up a little more detail down through here, just like kind of walk that across and just a little more shadow. And so there's one little sketch here, just kind of putting it all together, a nice little thumbnail study about getting it all started here. And you know, maybe another approach might be just coming back in again, just a nice little series of, let's just do this, round it out and again fan it out up on top and just begin to build this shape. Come through the center. The start button in this thing, maybe it's kind of stilted like that, just a couple of crow's feet on this thing. It's really nice, quick sketches. Come back inside this thing again, add a little bit of tone. Back through again, a lot more animation through the form itself. Tells me where our light source is coming from. It's on the, in this case, on the right hand side. So we're just coming through this thing, a little bit of the detail here. Just kind of pick this up and just get some, let's do this. Let's do this, this venting system here, air distribution coming out of those areas here. And again, let's turn this upside down, get a little bit of concept through this air, body on this guy, bring it around again. A little bit of tone, a little more depth in this thing. Again, since the light source is coming from there, it's going to pull this back in. Let's get that one to me here. Where the light source is coming from on that side, just a bit. So we're going to run that through just a touch. It's going to go back and reinforce some of that shadow. And again, just a little bit of pencil work to kind of give it more softness to it. Just kind of work it in here just a little bit, just kind of cut through it and just shape. More shadow on the inside portion here where it kind of comes back, this little flute that comes around and throws the air out. And again, a little bit more detail in this guy, a little bit of shadow in that foot. And again, here, just a touch there, and animation with some of the pencil work. Just kind of give it a little bit of zip. There it is. So just a nice little thumbnail sketch on what that guy's going to do in terms of just little thumbnails and getting a light source down. And just go back and through here. Just some real simple shapes here. Line weight in this thing. Again, a little bit of contour. A bit on off button up on top here. Just kind of, this is away from the light source. Just kind of tip that back just a bit. And again, catch a little bit of this form here. Highlight, just kind of get this thing just slowly but surely put a little bit of tone in this thing. Oh, there I am. Shadow down here. And again, last but not least, a little indication of where some little indications of some hot spots here. Coming down the line again, a little bit of tone here, saving that for the best for that. Just coming back a little bit of tone into that, and again into here, and again across that edge, and right through the shape, just real softly. And again, the little form on side here, and a little bit inside here, a little bit more graphics, and just a touch of that on the outside here. Just a nice little thumbnail study. More tone in this, a little bit of reflective light than that thing. And again, right through, put a little more line weight in this guy. It's a little secondary radius right there. Just bring this in. And again, three little quick studies there, just on putting form together and get an idea of just putting some little air purifier shapes together here to kind of work with. Let me sharpen this pencil a little bit here, gang. We'll go at it here. Hey, hi, Doc. What is it this time? I'm pretty good. That Starship, Nemo, I'm really sorry for the fact that I've lost my chat system here, but I wanted to go full steam anyhow. I'm just doing a series of little thumbnail sketches on the, some air purifiers, just looking at more of an exercise for me on volume studies, how to put together constructive systems and the like and make this thing work a little bit. So I'm just going through some real rapid little sketches here. Captain Nemo is just going to take that same shape up on top there. Do a little variation on theme here. Let's open this up just a bit more, put a little more of that hourglass look to it. Just open up this cylinder, this circle down below here. Now in this case, let's put that little ventilation system here. Let's open this up, split this through. And just really quick little gestures. Hope you can hear me all right, Captain Nemo. Boy, I really am sorry about the fact that this thing, for some odd reason, I lost my camera this morning. I had to get that back up again. And when I did that, I thought the chat system was going to be up and running. But here, lo and behold, I got started and sure, nothing available there at all as far as chat goes. So I hope this is coming through. Okay, hey, good. That's fine. So once again, I just thought we'd kind of pull. Let me hold on for a moment here, Captain Nemo. I thought we'd kind of pull back for the last couple of exercises. I did a whole lot of landscape portfolio work last time through. And I thought it'd be nice to go back and just do some very quick little thumbnail sketches on just volumetrics and in this case, air purifiers, looking at different ways of building a shape. And the reason I brought that to our attention, I decided to go that route today, was because a lot of questions are coming up now from individuals on the chat system about putting structure together. How do you build a shape? How do you begin to take a look at developing a compound or organic forms? Is there a secret to it? And there's really not a secret to it as much as there is understanding how volumes work. For example, this is a good example. These two are great examples of circles in perspective and how they can really begin to influence a shape. And so let's go back and look at this thing here. Let's see if I start there. Let's see if I add a dome to this thing. What happens there? Now, look what happens. That changes the entire character of that form. I come back in again and really web this thing back in. Begin to web this thing, open that up, and come back in the same kind of animation. Let's put a light source from the other side here where I put this in the shadow. Let's go back in through here. A little bit of tone down, run that through, and yet being consistent in the shape, run it right through. And again, let's pick up that same shadow. Let's drive the viewer back just a bit here. So notice how that expands, how that shadow is going to expand because of the nature of the shape. So let's go back in, add that same kind of process. Let's put that in here, into highlight. This is going to get much, a little bit more tone to it here. Work through it. Work through it again, add some more webbing in through here, more vein. Gonna break that up a bit. And again, at the very top, maybe a power button. It's gonna recess a little bit. It's got more of a little more shape. So we're just working up that concentric all the time there, Nemo, and now it all begins to work for us. So let's go back in through here. A bit of shadow. Find that a little bit more. Come back in with a pencil and kind of accent that in just a moment. Come back in through here. Same process. Coming in vertically. Notice there's my outer edge. One of the big mistakes we make in working with this round stuff is we kind of render or illustrate right to the edge. And I think it's always good to bring it inboard just a little bit. That's a little bit of this little area here, that little white area is reflected light. And it's the same with this guy, reflected light. Same with this, reflected light. Just let that kind of happen on the natural. I'll go through that in just a moment here and explain how that begins to happen. I'm just going to put the shadow down a little more fullness in this thing. Go back and pick up the volume and step inboard just a bit, tone it. Come through it and then release it. Working right through the shape, not being careful at all, just really gesturally getting an idea of the form down. Now let's hit the pencil out and put a more secondary tone in this thing. Let's kind of get this little dome up on top. It's going to do that. It's going to come back around again. It was here. A little shadow on the inside of that little recess area there. Fine. Back in through here, reinforce where that core is. Bring it out and then release it. Same thing across here. And again, in through here. And again, right under this. Draw through it. Draw through it. And a little bit more, just a little bit of reflective system right over here. Just kind of bring that on through and just let that kind of happen. There it is. Series of real quick little gestures. It's, isn't that called rim lighting? Yeah, in a sense it is. It's rim lighting. You're absolutely correct. That's a good way to describe it as well. You can come back in and just rim light it because that's and then reflected light. A little more shadow down in this guy. Let's get a little reinforcement here. And one more time here. Let's go back the other way. It's going to develop something that's again, a little bit of tone and the base in there to work with. And here we are here. I made some experiments with silk and velvet material rendering, and I found due to the shorter fuzz of the velvet, it has a strong rim light and almost no direct light. Yeah, that's it absorbs it all. You're right there, Nemo. It'll absorb it like you wouldn't believe. Pretty powerful stuff. It just animates the whole thing. And there you go. Let's kind of get this down here. Put a more tone on this thing, kind of break it up a little bit. Bit of a different base underneath this thing. Strengthen the sketch. And again, we'll surface in through here. Where the highlight is right along the edge. I'm just going to bring this into play. And again, release it. Out as we go. Out as we go. The shadow working through here. And again, let's reinforce what this guy is doing here. I'm just going to come back in and really strengthen where those areas are. A little bit of ventilation. Shadow definition in this guy. The ground line. And just quick little thumbnail sketches on how the whole opposition, how to begin to develop shape and form and putting these pieces together. And looking at, and primarily the thing is just to build the sketch and how the surfaces begin to work and how they begin to interact with light, detail, construction. All that material comes together. And I think a good exercise for me today to go back and do some basic fundamental architectural sketches here for some product design work. There's plate one. Let me just do this here again. That's that guy. Let's move on to another plate here. We're just going to keep building on some things as we go here. So there's sketch one. I'm going to go ahead and put this together with a little bit of a sharpener here. Get that all set up. And let's go back and go a little vertical with this thing now. Let's see what happens if we start to do this. This into play here just for a little bit. Get that up. There we are. Make it around the corner here and just kind of lean right back into where that form is doing. Put a shadow in this guy. Get this underneath here and kind of work. Come right across that face and just get a little bit of animation on that guy. And do this. Yeah, let's kind of pick up a little pattern here. We come right down the center line of this guy. Let's just put a center line down this thing, and let's bring it right into play here. There we are. One. Yeah, a bit of tone down below where it moves away from the light source. A bit of pen work in here, just going to get a little bit of scrub. Come back in through here. And again, a little more detail down below. It's going to really ink this in here. It's got a bit of shadow in this side here. Let's put this into play. And that intersection is here. Come right back in a bit of tone in it first. And come back in and really hit it. There's shadow base. We ground it just a bit here. And we'll come back in and just reinforce it here. A little more drawing definition in this guy. And again, just a touch more in through here. A little more romance in the form. And again, underneath. Let's take this guy across and out of the way. There's another little thumbnail sketch on, let's bring this back into play here. This little vertical system that we're looking at here. Now let's go the other way here for what it's worth. Sideways just a bit here. Get this down. A little recess in here, that form grows out of it. Pardon me. Secondary line that comes around and gives some thickness to the material. Let's run that in. And again, just a little bit of tone here. Whole thing is perfect. A little bit of ventilation that comes out of the sidewalls in this guy. There it is, a little bit of shadow underneath here. Put a little bit of floor reinforcement in that base area here. So back in. Again, a little bit more contour. A little bit of surface definition on the side. A little bit of indication where the light source is coming from. Up on top, and then just a touch more of adding a little bit of fill to this thing, a little more body to it, just kind of give it some impact. There it is. And again, down below. Real quick, very gesturally sketches. Not a lot of detail being involved in this stuff. Just getting the shapes down. And this is another little study. They're just getting nice and simple. Easy to go here. And what do you think so far, Captain Nemo? Is this making sense? Hope you're coming along okay. I'm really pleased you're on board today. That's really nice to have you on board here. Good stuff, man. So I hope you've been well and staying very busy. And I think let's go back to your question there about what you're doing with this whole thing about the idea about the silk. Yes, materials are really tough to work with because there's so much absorption when light hits them. But there's a lot of afterglow, reflected light, some especially off of silks. There's an extreme darks of lights. So it's a good exercise you're getting into there, Nemo. Very fun stuff. So let's go back and look at these guys here one more time. Let's get that up on place. Let's do a little bit more experimentation here. Let's kind of roll in this very round circle. This is a real good challenge because sometimes round forms are really tough to work with. So if we come back out of this and put a little bit of this into it. Come out of that, and then put that into it, draw through it. But at the same time, this is a really unique problem, because you've got really something very difficult to work with here. It's what I refer to as like a zero reference surface. Now it's living room appliances. It's difficult to work with because what are the real rationales here, for example? How do you break this shape up? Well, I always look at it from the point of view of being a very geometric form. It's really a construct of a lot of circles in perspective. So if you lightly draw through this guy, you'll see where the structures are. We're going to put a little bit of foot in this thing. It's going to put a more drum into this and round this off. Put a more drum into this. It's just going to get that shape to kind of come in and put that shadow down. There it is. Let's put a little shadow in it first so we kind of ground this thing. I'm going to break this thing up. Let's get that started. A little more tone in this. Now, the real issue at hand here is how do we handle, for example, that round form? Very difficult to deal with because all of a sudden we're the okay. Let's work with it here. Let's come back in and break this up. Let's go back in and add this. I'm going to take this and roll it out. Notice I'm following the contours. I'm going to pick up a center line here, that distance there, bring it right on through, break it out of that. See what I did there? followed that contour, brought in a gut and a cap. I'm going to come over the top now with the same thing, the same circle through here. My reference is going to be here, over the top, and over the top. And again, underneath. There I am. One, two. Let's come back in here. Let's put a little bit of toneness. Now, spherical, most of my light source is over here, so I'm gonna come back in through here and just tone this lower portion in right here. That's where the contour line is. And again, just maybe a sneaky little part of it right here. Take it on through. Let this all go animation. Draw back in again. Cast a shadow across this foot. Again, through here, cross that foot. And a little more depth in through here. A little more shadow. Shadow. Now, really hitting this thing. That's where the shoulder is going to be, right there. So that's going to step in. This is going to step in. This is going to step in. And that's going to step in. And this, so we're going to put a little bit of webbing here, or a little vein work, let the air distribute out of it. And again, vertical. And again, vertical, following the contour. And there it is. We're working with a round shape to get that form to read nicely. There's more volume to it here. And very little effort in terms of putting together a lot more rendering. It's just putting more tone in the shadow, more tone in the actual support feet. Same thing through here. And just enough of the contour in the actual sphere itself. I'm going to give it a little more animation. Where the hot spot is coming from, the light source. A little more tone in this thing. And there I am. That does it right there. There she is. It's nice and simple. Very easy, very generous sketches to work with. And again, go back in again with this very nice. Let's do this. What if we go the other way? What if we start out with a very round surface down here and then come out the center line and we extend that thing? And we change its character. And at the same time, we come back out here and just kind of flare it out just about right in there. Open that up and ground it. At the same time, put a little bit of stuff on top. Notice how I'm just working right through the shape, being really volumetric, just working right through it and not being concerned about limit lines or being very caustic in terms of being careful. Just a nice simple series of gestures here to get this thing done. So here we go. Let's go back in here. Put a light source on it. Into the negative. Again, here. This is where there might be a bit of a separation, so let's kind of put that in place. Go back in again. Bit of tone in this. You notice I'm stepping in. There's my limit line. I'm stepping in board just a bit. A little bit of rendering to it. A bit of tone. Come underneath here. I'm going to turn this upside down and put a little strong shadow in through here. Now I'm going to come back in, pick up the contour. Shadow. Back to form. In the base. Sideways just a bit, warm into it, and a little more contouring through here, where the shadow is. The base kind of opens up a bit, there. And again, a little bit of detail, ventilation. And just a little more tone to it. And there you are. A little study again. It all comes together here, hopefully. So, let's see. Nemo, such as this, if you're still on board there, I hope this is helping. Am I kind of describing things okay here as far from a structural point of view and how to begin to develop some of these forms? It's very, very sensitive stuff, but I just don't want to rush through it too quickly here. And hopefully I'm making sense. And I really feel badly about the fact I've lost my chat line here, so I can communicate back and forth here with you guys. So thank you very much for being patient here. Let's go back and just do some really quick little animation sketches here. Just going to open this thing up just a bit. Just do some real fast gestures. The tone changing here. And again, a bit of contour to it, a little bit of body in this thing. Again, so composition studies here. And they're just really fast little empathy sketches about what these forms might look like and what they could bring to generate. It's just kind of fun to deal with this. Again, I'm really concentrating on just putting gesture down, getting back to some fundamental things in terms of just putting structure together. Nothing really fancy here, folks. Just some really good old-fashioned sketches in terms of being very lucid with it and not being fearful about making mistakes and the like. Just not the possibility of coming along here for the ride. So let's just kind of sign this guy and we'll start another print here. What do you think, Nemo? It's coming together all right? You still with us? I hope this is helping in some way, shape, or form. Again, just really fast little gesture sketches in terms of what do you do in terms of putting together like a, in this case, an air purifiers. Are they really that, they're not exciting, but they're good volume studies because there's a lot of different forms and different textures that kind of take place in the process itself. So it's kind of neat to be able to go through these sketches. Really interesting things to kind of deal with. So let's go back here, just a couple more pages here. Let's kind of set the perspective up and then they're real loose. Let's come back in and just kind of thread this and just do this. I'm gonna start with a little afterburner here. Let's kind of pull this back just a touch. A little bit of an offset. Sideways just a bit. And then let's come back in with a bit of a brow on this thing. That's that. Now we've got that set up here. It's going to bring this into play. A little bit of a break here. Notice drawing right through it where the highlight is, where the radius is. Going back in to get this thing. Kind of plugs in here. That's the following. Comes in behind the shape. Put a shadow down first. It's going to get that started here. And just kind of get some things rolling here. Now let's go back in and get a little bit of texture. A bit of an offset. Pardon me, as I rotate the pad just a bit of paper. There it is there. A little bit of the shadow going in through here. A bit of ballpoint pen. And the highlight. Again, then the radius. In shadow. And again, in the shadow. Overhang. Again, just real simple stuff up on top. Maybe it's just this into this and just tone it. And a little bit of an edge here. And back in and reinforce where that radius is. Turn it sideways just a bit. More shape in the spotty side here. And again, a little bit of an edge in this guy, a little more drawing definition. And again, over the top. And there we are. There's another little thumbnail sketch on putting together a little bit of a vertical system here and going through the whole idea of just generating shape. Yeah, let's go back in. Tone Jade. So we're going to this guy. And there's another little study just looking at basic volumes. We're back on Jet Power Pencil. Yeah, that's right. Hey, how you doing, Chip? Good to have you on board here. I really want to apologize. I started the program here today. I don't have my chat. I lost my chat series here, so I've got to get that thing back. There was a reboot that took place, and I thought we were all set to go. And when I started the thing up, I didn't see the chat line come up. So my apologies, Chip. Hope you're doing well. Thank you for joining us. I'm just going through a whole series of just little thumbnail sketches on air purifiers. Just going back to some basic things like volumetric studies, how to put together shape and perspective, and breaking things down a little bit. I'll go through a review here in a moment if you're with us for a little bit of time here. I'm doing well, thanks, Chip. And again, so sorry for the inconvenience of this. No chat and so forth. But let's go back here one more time. Just go back and just do a nice little series of elongated shapes. You're just going to put the perspective down and just kind of get this guy tuned in. And let it go with that. Just a radius. A radius. Keep a nice simple line drawing like that, and then just offset it, go back to center line, and just break it up. There's a basic premise. It tells where the light source is coming from. Kind of tune this back just a bit. Getting through here. A little bit of shadow underneath this guy, a little bit of contour to it. Tells me there's a bit of an offset in there. Again, along this parting line here. And this comes across, pardon me for rotating the paper. Now, let's just do a little simple trick here. It's going to get this thing just up to the edge. Just do a little detail work here. Just a bit of tone. A little bit of tone, break the edge, break the edge. Get that in place, take it across the top, bring a little bit of inboard, and just a touch right down that seam line right there. It's going to bring out the form through, and then a little bit of exaggeration here. It's just going to, let's break that side away from it, more of a stealth. Break up here, changing that just a touch. And again, last but not least, again, a little bit of a sway line in through here, just kind of bring this on through, a little more melodic in the sidewall. Take that right on through. And let's get this going to come in, strengthen it, up, over the top, through it. And last but not least, exercise for line discipline as well. Just getting these things to kind of all line up for you, just putting a little bit of detail in these things makes a huge difference in terms of putting together the perspective. So let me just put a little more tone in this thing here, kind of separate this just a bit more. That's better, a little healthier. So far, so good. Put that in that, and again, where the light source is coming from, no problem. A little harder tone here, kind of separate them. And again, just a whole series of fanciful little, maybe some elevation sketches here and what these things might look like. Let's throw on this guy, a little elevation study here. Again, same process. A little bit of tone underneath here. Shadow work, shadow in there. A little bit of that form study here. Break that out of it and just bring it right down the line and then get a little bit of that back wash in here. And then that should do it right about there. A little change of pace. That's kind of neat. Let's add that little addendum back there. Just kind of give it more interest. And bring it back in. And again, highlight line. And again, little thumbnail sketches on just quick architectural stuff. Just really good, fun stuff to kind of generate some more interest with this stuff here. So last but not least, just going to go back and do that same old process again. Let's go back and do this, get into some of this. Again, a bit of tone. Get that thing to read like a sphere. Real quick animated sketches, just putting some form together, looking at simple shapes and how they'll begin to function. So I think for what it's worth, I mean, I think we've done a pretty good job of putting together some really quick loose thumbnail sketches on just, again, the practice today was just to get in the habit, back into the habit of developing just shape and contour studies. Again, it's product design exercise, but it was more in terms of looking at maybe an air purifying system, looking at different shapes, how to build those forms. And I think kind of a nice change of pace for me anyhow today, because I know we've gone through some portfolio review work, we've done some very extensive rendering work, but just sometimes going back to just basics is really a good healthy process to get into. So let me just do this for your benefit here, Kip. I'll show you what we started here. Just some review here. And again, if Captain Nemo, if you're still there, what do you think, man? This makes sense today, gang? Really appreciate you joining forces. Again, my sincere apologies for no chat. I can't respond back and forth here to each one of you. So sorry for that. We'll get that organized before next Tuesday when we start again here. So this is where I started. Just a nice series of little thumbnail sketches on putting together. Started with this one, volumetrics, and just changing the shape. And ballpoint pen and Prismacolor pencil. Just putting some lucid sketches together. And just neat stuff as far as detail goes, how to put together surface and form, and being very, very vaporous with it. Vaporous in the sense that notice every one of these sketches has a lot of paper showing through. And I think that's the secret to the success of a really good thumbnail sketch or any idea that you put together. Let the paper operate. Just interesting stuff how if you spend more time with the form being right, it takes very little time to put a lot of detail in. You have to kind of fill it all in. Let it become mysterious. What's that shape really doing? How do we develop certain forms? How complex can we make it? How simple can we make it? So there was plate number one there, gang. And plate number two, we kind of rotated out of that thing. There's plate number one, second plate, a little bit more adventuresome in terms of shape and development. You're a little family of forms in through here to kind of take advantage of this spherical piece. But again, notice again, very little of it all filled in, a lot of paper coming through because I'm letting the volume do the work, and I'm understanding I'm really capturing as well the light source and how it begins to affect each one of these shapes. So light source and volumetrics, really critical stuff. And again, the reason today for putting the stream on was to go back to that basic fundamental truth that if you understand how volumetrics work, then the light source, how it functions with it, all of a sudden everything becomes much more magnified and much, much easier to handle. So again, that's the rationale for me. I went back to practice today to kind of keep myself lucid and keep those little principles of truth operating. And the last page we did here was this guy where we came back out of it, just did a little variation on form, same basic simple form, getting ideas down and just putting shape together and saying, okay, what happens in rectangular form? And again, variations on theme. Notice again, all the paper is open up and very little contour. I'm just hitting where the volume strengths are and what the volumetrics are telling me to do with it. So again, today, product design, concept sketches on air purifiers, but underneath it all was more of an exercise in building the structure, seeing the volume, and then letting the light source do the work for you. So I hope this has been some help to you. And if you have any questions or concerns, please drop me a note at my email address at jim@drcontrast.com. If you have an interest in looking at maybe some drawing exercises to help you through the process, I've got a very good on my website at drcontrast.com. I've got a very interesting format in terms of basic drawing lessons. It's coming along very nicely. Soon we'll be adding some more things like some really fast little 10-minute little snippets on YouTube and try to do a simulcast between Twitch and YouTube to get it up there at the same time. And I'll be doing a lot of little thumbnail studies or exercises on how to develop automotive proportion, product design, architecture, interior space, taking the whole thing through and doing a series of really, really fast little exercises on how to set up proportions, scale, color, texture, volume, etc., light source, all those pieces in motion. So all that to say, gang, this is where we are today. Got all three of these put together. There's where I started. Put these back in the plate. There it is. And I really do thank you, Captain Nemo, for joining me. And Chip, it's good to have you on board as well. Back in the jet power pencil sharpers, yeah, we could call them that. And again, I really appreciate you guys joining forces today. And again, so thankful that you stuck with me because of the chat system I'm losing here. So I'll get that back on board for next week. Hopefully we get this fixed. I think what happened, the process, OBS rebooted and some things came through. I had to adjust my camera this morning a little bit, but I thought for sure that the chat was working. But when I went live, sure enough, it wasn't there. So my apologies, gang. All the very best to you. Take care. Have a great day. And always remember this. I will sign off with this because I think it's the most important part of the whole stream. Never forget to remember to dare to be great because you are. Thanks very much, gang. All the very best and take care. We'll see you next Tuesday. Bye-bye now.